council in this hour. Thou hast created the very air as a medium. Thou hast given bands to the throats of men and women to vibrate the air. Thou hast put little drums in our ears to receive the vibrations that are made by ourselves and by others. And thou hast created man capable of inventing instruments that imitate the human voice. Thou hast also given man the ability to invent rhythms and melodies that give delight. In 1756, it was thy pleasure to create Amadeus Mozart and endow him with the talent to compose music that gives delight to all who have ears to hear and hearts to feel. Amadeus was part of mankind for just 35 years. And when he died, O Lord, as thou knowest, he left as the capstone of his work the wonders to which we here in this church give voice this afternoon. We do it to the honor, the greater glory of thy name, O Lord, and to the memory of those who have passed on, our friends, our loved ones, our mothers, our fathers, our brothers, our sisters, even some of our children. Some of our teachers, our pastors, our lawyers, our doctors, our nurses, our neighbors. And we thank thee that we had them, and that with the hope that is voiced in this requiem, we can someday be reunited with them. And we thank thee that we had Mozart. And we give this to thee, O Lord, today as the most precious musical gift that is in our power. We do so in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you.
Response to this musical experience would be the words of the psalmist David in Psalm 95, when he sang these words: "Worship the Lord in the splendor of his holiness. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due his name. Bring an offering and come into his courts." We invite you today to bring an offering in response to this music and to the musicians of the University Church, and to show your expressions of gratitude
to God, and to the music department for this glorious music. Thank you. The deacons will now wait for me.
Thank you.
now may the love of God, our Father, and the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the sweet comfort and communion of His Holy Spirit go with you now and always.